Hi, welcome to PiSignage. My name is Rajat and I cover all things design and product here at PiSignage. In today's video, we're going to show you how to turn your Raspberry Pi into a PiSignage player. We're going to download everything we need, build and set up a Raspberry Pi, register the player, and deploy our first image right onto the screen that you see right here. For today, we're going to need a Raspberry Pi, an SD card. We also have the power source and HDMI cable to connect it to the screen right here, and our laptop. To get started, I'm going to go here to PiSignage.com, and on the top tab, I'm going to click on Downloads. This should take you to our GitHub page. Our GitHub page has a README file which has all of the important information you would need to set up your player. But for now, I'm going to scroll down to getting the player ready. Over here, you'll see that we have three different OSs, 5.0.4, 4.9.0, and 3.2.0. Which OS you use would be dependent on the Raspberry Pi you have right now. I'll be using the Pi Model 5. For this, I will need to download 5.0.4. So I'm simply going to click on the OS and start the download. Now, some customers copy paste this directly onto the SD card, and this unfortunately won't work. The second part of what you need is an imaging software. I'm just going to scroll down on this page a little further, and over here you can see in number 2 that we talk about a few applications that we recommend, namely Raspberry Pi Imager and Billane Imager. I'm going to click on Raspberry Pi Imager, and this is going to take us to the Raspberry Pi OS website. This software is open source, no payment required, and should work as is. So I'm going to scroll down and download it for Mac OS. They do have a Windows and Ubuntu version as well. So now that we have both of these downloading, it may take a few minutes. It's been a few minutes now and our downloads have completed. I've moved them into a folder called Raspberry Setup. This is when you should plug in your SD card to your laptop. So I'm going to just plug it in right here. Depending on the device you're using, you may need an external hardware to connect the SD card to your machine. In my case, I need this SD card to USB-C converter. I'm going to see it over here as new disk. I'm going to click on Raspberry Setup and open the imager. Over here, we should see Raspberry Pi Imager, and opening that, I should see a prompt asking for the device, operating system, and storage. I'm just going to close these so that we can focus on the imager. So you can ignore the Raspberry Pi device. On operating system, you want to open up this prompt, which shows you a few Raspberry Pi OSs that are pre-built. What you want to do is scroll all the way to the bottom, where you should see an option that says Use Custom. So I'm going to click on Use Custom. And over here, I'm going to click on the image that we downloaded. This would vary based on the image you chose to download from our GitHub. But in my case, I'm going to choose 5.0.4. I'm going to click on Open. And the next part is choosing my storage, which should be straightforward as the new disk. From there, I'm going to click on Next. This should start the process of writing the OS onto your SD card. And it may take a few minutes, about 10 to 15 minutes. While this is going on, there will be three things that happen. First, the imager is going to write onto your SD card, then it's going to verify, and finally it's going to show you a prompt telling you that it's done. Once you're done writing to your SD card, you want to safely eject it. Take the SD card and plug it right here into the Raspberry Pi. You want to make sure that it's all the way in. From here, we're going to connect it to the screen that we have here. So I'm just going to connect the power source and the HDMI cable, and now a Raspberry Pi should be connected to the screen that we have here. Now that we have the Raspberry Pi connected to the screen, we should see the PiSignage logo, and it should soon switch to a screen where we see the player ID right up top here and all of the connection statuses that are relevant. So now we're going to connect our Raspberry Pi to the internet before we register the player. And that's going to be as simple as following the instructions on screen. I'm going to go here to my Wi-Fi settings, click on Other Networks, and I should see Pi Player. I'm going to click on Pi Player, and on being prompted for the password, I'm going to type in PiPlayer. I'm going to click on show password. In most cases, PiPlayer is the password. I'm going to click on join, and this should connect me to the Wi-Fi. Now that we are connected to the network, I'm just going to open up a new tab, and I'm going to type in the address that's shown right here. Once you type in your address, you'll be prompted for your username password. Simply type pi, which is P and I, for the username, and PI for the password. Click on sign in. The player interface will allow you to manage the player specifically. You can change playlists, you can add local assets, and you can change the settings. For now, since we want to connect it to the Wi-Fi, I'm going to click on settings. I'm going to scroll down right here to Wi-Fi settings. I'm going to choose normal Wi-Fi instead of act as access point. I'm going to click on scan network, which should show me all of the available Wi-Fi's. So I'm just going to select one here and type in my password. Once you're done typing in the password, click on save. This should restart your player with the updated Wi-Fi settings. So we're just going to wait for the player to restart. As you can see, our player has now restarted with the Wi-Fi settings applied. We see the familiar PiSignage screen, and we see the status screen again. It may take up to 30 seconds for the connection status to change from disconnected to connected. But for now, I'm just going to go ahead and register the player. To register a player, we're going to go to PiSignage.com and sign in. You may have to sign up if you don't already have an ID. Over here, we're going to players, and within players, I'm going to click on register a new player. Over here, we're going to enter the 16-digit player ID, which is the player ID that's up top over here. So in this case, I'm going to type it in. We can change the default group. We could change the time zone. We can name the player. I'm just going to name it Demo TV, and we can add a player location, in which case I'm just going to enter Bengaluru. From there, I'm just going to click on register, which should register our player. You can see here that it's been registered. The player does require an update, and you can see the current playing playlist along with the status. Right now, it says that it's online, but there is no playlist playing. That's going to be an easy fix. I'm just going to go to my groups. I'm going to click on the default group, and over here we can see that our player is part of the default group. I'm just going to change the default playlist to a playlist that I already made previously called My First Playlist. And from there, I'm just going to click on deploy. We can now see that the download has started and our assets are now playing on the screen. With that, we come to the end of our video. We hope that this video has been helpful to you. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. We do also have an Android and a PW player, and I'm going to cover how to register those in future videos. With that being said, thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.